Good day, fellow investors. Yes, when stocks go down, it's a good day for value investors. Now the question is there enough blood in the streets, especially in emerging markets, to buy in? For that, to answer that question, I want to discuss my investment strategy when it comes to emerging markets. How do I deal with volatility? What is my entry point? How many entry points do I have? And I'll also explain how emerging markets really work, so you'll have a better perspective on how to approach. And then the question will be answered, whether to buy or not now. Tomorrow, I'll make a video more on the fundamentals. What do I look at and how do I approach analyzing a stock before I invest in an emerging market? What are the fundamentals? What are the earnings? What is the business? What is it that I look at? I had great winners last year. Some of you enjoyed them with UPI, YY. So how do I get to those stocks? What is my risk reward analysis and how do I get that? More about that tomorrow. Let's dig into the strategy to invest in emerging markets today. If we look at the emerging market chart, this is iShares China ETF. So look at first the long-term perspective. Everybody looks at today's change, last week's change, but look at the long-term perspective. Year to date, we are down only 8%. On top of that, if you look at a longer-term perspective, since the January 2016 low till the top that was reached somewhere in January of this year, it was up. The index, the ETF for China, is up 100%. 100% and now 8% down. So it's not that big. 15-20% down if you look at from the peak in late January, but still we are still relatively high. The 5-year change is 35%. The 3-year change, 2-year change is almost what, 50-60. So good returns. We are still in very, very positive territory. How big is the downside? Look at this. 2014, it was below 50, the ETF, now it's at 60, so it's not that far. When there was the fear about China crisis, January 2016, it went below 40. So that's still what, 30-40% downside possibility. That depends a lot on sentiment. And that is exactly why emerging markets, and especially individual emerging market stocks, are extremely volatile, because it is so much about sentiment. And when people get scared about the risks, as now is going on with Turkey, Argentina, emerging market risk, they immediately sell emerging markets and everybody has a domestic bias and runs into what they know best, and that's domestic stocks, domestic treasuries. That's why the dollar is strengthening. Everybody has always used the dollar as a safe haven, and now everybody's rushing towards the dollar and sell whatever you can in those emerging markets. And as those ETFs are being sold, those ETFs have to sell their respective positions, and there is no buyer, because when everybody is panicking, simply the markets are shallow, there is no buyer, there is no institutional buyer, perhaps even no market makers, and simply the stock then drops. And if you know that there is no buyer, then the short sellers start selling if they can, and then really it's a downward spiral extremely fast. And you see a lot of the red happening that you're probably seeing on your emerging market screener. Now, the question is, okay, there is a lot of red, nobody's buying. Is it now time to do the opposite what everybody else is doing and buy? There are two things to watch there. One is, okay, the fundamentals, more about that tomorrow. And the second thing is, it's all about the strategy. When approaching investing market, it is almost as important as to pick the right stocks to have a right strategy. Because you might pick the right stock, you might be right about the fundamentals, the business, everything, but you might not be right about the market. And that's something you have to implement in your strategy. For example, everybody's panicking about China, but the Yuan has lost only 9% since what? Since April. And if you look at from last winter, fall, it is down just 4% against the US dollar. Everybody is panicking, all hell is breaking loose, but the currency is really, really stable. Nevertheless, the stocks are extremely volatile, but the businesses are stable. And this is what I do, this is my strategy. So I always look at the business. Okay, what would I be happy owning that business and what is the intrinsic value of the business, no matter what happens to the currency, economy, long-term, trade war, who cares about, I don't know, it was Korea last year, everybody was panicking about Korea. So when I can find a business and I can find its long-term earnings power, long-term strength, fundamental strength, no matter what happens, always markets, economies will always be volatile, then I have the intrinsic value. I discount it for all the risks, currency devaluation, China government implementation, whatever, and then I have an intrinsic price, which is extremely low. I require a return of 15% on my analysis. But given the volatility those emerging markets have, those target prices are here and there reached. And then I don't buy with everything I have. Then I have my first entry point, then lower than that is the second, third, and fourth entry point on each intrinsic value with a bigger margin of safety. Why do I have four entry points? Because I never know what will be the sentiment, what will be the decline in the next 5-6 months, because this can continue to bleed as it can go up and shoot up. Nobody knows whether it will go up or down. I just know that in the long term, it's always about fundamentals, and those fundamentals give me the certainty to buy more, even if others are selling. So, as I have said in the previous videos about my portfolio, I'm pretty heavy into cash. Even in the model portfolio on the research platform, heavy in cash, we are waiting for opportunities, we are analyzing companies. A lot of those companies are here demonstrated on YouTube. You have seen the latest video about Jiangsu Expressway. So there will be more and more stock analysis, intrinsic values. And when the price is below the intrinsic value, then we start slowly buying, accumulating. When it comes back, we sell part of the portfolio. So it's really, one thing is stock picking, the other is portfolio management, so that you don't get caught up in the red in days like this. I'm very happy today. I just hope those stocks on my screen go a little bit lower and some of them touch the buying ranges. Some of them are really close, but not yet, so I didn't buy anything today. If you really want to see in depth what am I doing, what am I buying, my portfolio, check my stock market research platform. The link is in the description below. There is even a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can just check it. If you're not happy, it's not for you, you get your money back. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, as there will be plenty more stock analysis, stock market investing ideas, where I share a bit what I do, as I do so many research that only a few get onto my coverage buying list. Thank you for watching, looking forward to your comments, hope it is a good day for you, and I'll see you in the next video.